Hello, so this is a tutorial for focusing on green plant intersection, especially on the pipe and how to get the shift boost. And I will get there first and then I can explain my setup. Okay, so as you approach the track here, you will see this big blue line, and next to it on the left this gray line. And where you want to be to get the shift boost is that you want to be in between of those, and you want to be a bit more on the left than on the right, so a bit nearer to the gray line. And there are three things that can happen. One thing that can happen is that you hear a bumping sound but you don't get a shift boost. This usually means that you were too far on the left, so somewhere over here like I am. And if you just go by without anything, without leaving a track, then you usually were too far on the right. And if you are in between of those, then you should get a shift boost. And you can also get a double shift boost. I'm not so sure about that, but maybe also a triple. So you can go really fast. And I will try to get it now. Too far on the right. Okay, got a double. So that was the right angle and the right position. So now I'm going to explain a setup for boost lab. How to set up the first shift boost and how to get more shift boost. If you are going fast, then the setup for more shift boost in the tunnel, so if you always the same, and actually pretty simple. Okay, so you could see me here doing a little quick turn before or in the little curve there, and I want to do this to kind of line up with this blue line, like just to be somewhere over here and going straight. And what the track does is that it lines you up for the shift boost itself, so you don't have to hold right left or press LR or anything. Just hold A or and a little in the end, if the boost is not long enough, and you should get the shift boost. The angle for getting the shift boost here is pretty much the angle that you want to get for more shift boost. Sometimes it might not line you up correctly, but you can do a little adjustment of course. Okay, so okay. Well, let's get that in. Well, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I tried to get it in lap 3. And shift boost. Okay, and I fucked it up. That's bad. Okay, let me try again so I can tell you how to get more shift boost if you are already going fast. That was far on the left. Okay, that was a shift boost, but not a double. Ah. Okay. So let's get a double 50. Okay, so now I got a double shift boost, and usually you're always kind of in the same position if you go fast, so you won't be somewhere over here or over here, you will always be somewhere over here, and you want to approach the uphill from the left side. I will try to get it now. Okay, so I'm on the left side now. And there is about the peak, and you want to switch from the left side to the right side as you approach this peak here. And well, if you just go in the air and don't get a shift boost, then you were too far in the left, and if you don't leave the track at all, then you were too far in the right. And usually to get it, you only need to slightly hold left. Okay. Yeah, this time I was far on the right, for example. Let's try again. Also, if you want to learn it, then I recommend watching Fakester's video. He does the setup pretty well. Like, not all of that what I do, but kind of. Oh, come on, I wanna go to the truth and the double when I don't need it. Okay, whatever. So, for demonstration purposes, I want to show how much the shift boosting saves, and it's a lot of time. So this is my PB goes, and it gets a double at the first, yeah, possible hill, or in the first hill, and it gets every single shift boost after it, except for that one edge shift boost, but I just let that aside now, and we will see how much this will save compared to a run that doesn't get the shift boost. Okay, so I'm just going along the red blue line to not get the shift boost. Okay. And 5 seconds, 6 seconds. Yeah, and sum up about 7 seconds, and that is a lot. And it also saves time in boost laps, so you want to go for it on whenever you can.